In this segment, we're going to talk about pH balance and the role that it plays in our health. And Dr. Starkey, we have another demonstration here. What are we doing here?
We're all about demonstrations because
yeah,
I think
are.
That once demonstration, you know, once we see the response, it's a lot easier for us to you know, take the product,
right,
I believe.
Right.
Let's discuss real quickly pH balance. Again, we've touched on this several times, but I think it's so important that we understand that our diets are a huge, you know, reason for this fluctuation in our body's pH.
Right.
Because again, when we're cooking it, nuking it, eating it out of a can or through a pickup window, these foods are very acid. And what does that actually mean? I mean pH. pH stands for potential hydrogen.
Okay.
So in this case, if we eat those types of foods, you know, high sugar, you know, they're basically dead food, cause our bodies to be acidic.
Right.
Now,
I'm kind of a sweet tooth, so this is perfect for me.
Yet at the same time, when we take it from this, you know, when we take it from the true diet that we should be eating,
right,
and the fact of eating raw fruits and vegetables and nuts, and I mean, there's not a lot of people doing that. In fact, what's really frightening to me is the ones that are doing it are typically ones that are either fighting a health condition or have battled one.
Right.
So in this case, what I'd like to do is let's go ahead and think about it. pH balance. We can live how long without food? 2 to 3 weeks?
Yeah, something like, yeah.
Most of society thinks 2 to 3 hours, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Yet at the same time, we can live 2 to 3 days without water, which we basically don't drink enough water to begin with.
Right.
And yet we can only live 2 to 3 minutes without oxygen.
Right.
Yeah, right. So the most important aspect of our existence is the element of oxygen. And relating that back to pH is that the higher the acidity in our body's lack of oxygen or oxygen deprived environment,
okay,
the higher the pH in our bodies, of course, oxygen enriched. And there's our protection because that's what our foods do for us. That's what our bodies, that's our protection, and our food should be feeding that. Now, we're going to take it again from a demonstration standpoint. This is just a simple pH test kit. I'm going to go ahead and fill this.
So you can get something like this just like at a pool supply store,
sure,
or something.
Sure,
like.
A water store, absolutely.
Okay, or a water store.
Yeah,
right.
And basically what we're doing here is we're just filling this side up right here. As you can see, it's color-coded.
This is just the water that we've been using, right?
Right, and to think about this, the range on the pH goes from 0 to 14.
Okay.
The lower the number, the higher the acidity. The higher the number, the higher the alkalinity.
Now, okay, so we want a higher number.
Higher number.
What's like an ideal pH, for example?
Again, this is a topic that we really have to focus on because we don't want to over-alkalize our bodies because that could be just as deadly as becoming too acidic. So even if our blood, and ultimately it's our blood pH that we really need to focus on here, because our blood has to remain perfectly balanced.
Yeah.
And of course, the way our bodies do that is called a osmosis or homeostasis, or the blood has that perfect balance. Now, here's what happens is that as we eat or drink certain foods, our bodies have to rob, basically, because if it's not in our diet to begin with, our body's robbing its storage base in order to maintain that blood balance. So in other words, it robs from tissues, organ, and eventually the bone.
Okay.
And that's
like
where
calcium in the bones or something like
that,
right?
In this case, to maintain that proper blood pH, our body has to utilize, if it's not in our diet, it has to utilize it from our makeup.
Yeah.
And that's where we're, and to me, that's a deadly combination. Right now, we don't drink enough water. Our foods are basically dead and very acidic.
Right.
And at the same time, when we get to that mineral deficiencies that we've been discussing, that is a major culprit, or in this case, a major piece of that health puzzle that is not there to protect us.
Okay. Right.
So I'm going to go ahead and, if you would for me, Scott, I'm going to go ahead and put what's called phenol red, which is the acid that tests for pH balance.
Okay.
I'm going to put 5 drops here in this water. And what this will do is this will give us a base solution. We're going to go ahead and turn that upside down. You can see that response.
Right. So it's pretty, It's relatively...
It's neutral. Now, remember, neutral is 7, okay? That's where blood, and again, depending on what you're looking at or what study you're looking at, blood ranges from about 7.3 to 7.4,
okay?
So what I'd like to do is I'm going to go ahead and put, or let's go ahead and you put a drop of... Of this.
Colloidal minerals?
No, let's go ahead and put a drop of that.
So soda pop. I mean, so many people, soda pop is probably, people probably drink soda pop more than they drink water in this
And
country,
let's put this into perspective here. Do you know how many cups of water it takes to neutralize, just to neutralize one 20-ounce soda pop in your diet or in your body?
I don't. I'm not sure about that.
32 cups of water.
Wow.
32. Now, think about that. Most of your pop drinkers don't drink 32 cups of water in a month.
Yeah.
But they drink five or six of those a day, right?
Right.
So at the same time, that's where this is probably the most acidic solution that we willingly dump, you know, pour into our systems willingly.
Right.
And of course, the aftermath we don't directly associate with our health and being what we're drinking.
Yeah. Okay. So put a drop of this.
Put one drop into
this. Keeps fizzing up.
Put one little drop. Yep.
Okay.
I'm gonna go ahead and shake that up. Did you see
happened? So it's completely yellow, which
is completely acidic. So if you look at it here,
acid area.
Completely acidic. So right. In this case, doesn't surprise.
Well, obviously, it's
completely doesn't surprise
acidic.
Us. So what I'd like to do then is I'd like to go ahead and test the minerals that we've discussed. Right.
Okay.
I want to go ahead and test. If you would for me, Scott, take this colloidal mineral and put one drop into that acidic solution.
The same solution.
Just put it one drop.
Okay.
We're going to go ahead and now.
Well, it didn't really change.
Didn't change.
No.
So, again, with what we already, you know, experienced in the last segment, we now understand that from a pH standpoint, it doesn't affect that acidity.
Okay, right.
What I'd like to do is go ahead and take, if you would for me, one drop of the ionic, well, in this case, the ionic trace mineral drops, right?
Okay.
Concentrate.
Just one drop?
One drop.
Okay. Oh, wow, I can already see it.
And did you see that response?
it took it right back to a high
alkaline pH. Now, think about that. Now, you can see that
it actually balanced it out just pretty much.
So let's go ahead and do this again. I want you to put one more drop into that.
Okay.
And
well, that actually tells us how
acidic
the
soda pop is, right? But what I wanted to truly show is that that's our protection.
Oh, there we go. Okay, so with just two drops.
That pH balance, or in this case, that high alkaline environment, or that balance from an alkaline standpoint is that oxygen-rich environment that we're trying to create to protect our health.
Right.
And that ultimately is the power of the concentrated trace mineral drops.
Right. Okay. Well, thanks, Dr. Starkey.
Thank you.